Hi, everybody. This is a 100% horsehair brush, sterilized. Our cat was walking around up on this desk earlier today. I want to show you something. This is an old Western Auto catalog. Western Auto, the family store. Look at the clothing that they're wearing and hairstyles. It's a pretty good sized catalog. It's 1969 through 70. So this catalog is over a half century old. I wish you could smell. Wish you could smell this catalog. It definitely smells like it's over half a century old. So I have a question for you. That question is, can a catalog that's over a half century old make you sleepy? Let's find out. Here's some television sets. Price-wise, TV sets were pretty expensive back then. And you can tell it by looking at some of the prices. Like this 20-inch TV is $429. Yeah. This 18-inch TV is $349. This 14-inch TV is $269. That's a lot of money because the average income back in 1969 was less than $10,000. I think it was like $8,000 or maybe $9,000. And a lot of things cost way less than they do today back then. But for some reason, TV sets were still pretty expensive. I mean, here, that's about a 25-inch TV. That's $539.95. You can buy a much larger TV now for a lot less than that. But you know what? Back in 69, even though the TV sets cost a lot, your average house was only $15,000 to $16,000. I think the average house these days is $300,000 to $500,000. It's kind of ridiculous. Here's some black and white TVs, I think, yeah. Here's some guitars. $78 for this one. Here's one, let's see, number 6. I was gonna say that looks a lot like the shape of the guitar Paul McCartney from the Beatles would play. And it does say Beatle bass. Yeah, it's a Beatle bass guitar. Give you a close-up view of that. This magnifying glass belonged to my grandfather. He used it all the time. There's some solid-state electronic organs. There's a banjo down here. And some drum sets. Some saxophone. What did that saxophone cost? Number 10, a alto saxophone, $219. Wow. My son is a pretty good saxophone player. I spent a lot more than $219 on saxophones when he was still in school. There's a four-track reel-to-reel. It's $189. That's pretty neat. It's an expensive format. reel-to-reel might be the most expensive format of music. I was listening just today to cassettes. I was showing them to my granddaughter. She'd never seen a cassette before. So that was fun, showing her those. There's some more reel-to-reels. Another format of music was 8-track cartridges. Here's an 8-track player that you would mount under the dashboard of your car. In 1969, I can't say for sure if... I don't recall any cars coming with 8-track players from the factory. I'm sure there must have been some that did. But nobody I know had one from the factory with an 8-track player. I had a Pontiac Trans Am. It was a 1973. And it had a factory 8-track player. But in 69 and 70, I can't say. A-tracks are pretty much dead. Though I still listen to them. I still make recordings using those. Here's some walkie-talkies. And solid-state mobile transceiver. I don't guess that's a CB. In 1969, I don't think they called them CBs. That's 5 watts. And I think CB radios were limited to 4 watts. Here's some AM/FM clock radios over here. Here's some portable radios. I like radios. I appreciate radios quite a bit. Especially good quality portables. Transistor radios are pretty popular. Very collectible, too. Transistor radios, just a little handheld radio. Back then, when we were kids, most of us had a little AM/FM radio. Portable phonograph and AM/FM Here's just phonographs. Another word for these are just record player. Now they're not turntables. They're record players. They have an amplifier and a speaker built into them. Where generally a turntable doesn't have speakers. Seems like I remember my mom had something like this. It's funny how I had not thought about that until just now. And my mom had a pretty decent Elvis Presley record collection. She really did like Elvis. Here's some furniture that's got a record player and AM/FM radio built into the furniture. That's one thing we did back then, you know, people, they didn't want, you know, separate components sitting out. They wanted their stuff built into wooden furniture for a nice, clean, uncluttered look. And really, they're pretty cool. I mean, look at this. We called them AM/FM phono consoles. All that rich wood. You could put stuff on top of them, you know. Sometimes I wish we could go back to that. I have a pretty good hi-fi system. It's all separate components. But the truth is, they're kind of ugly, you know. They're kind of ugly compared to furniture like that. So, red spot on my finger, I was demonstrating a spirograph toy to my granddaughter today. And the red pin somehow leaked onto my finger. So, that's not blood or anything like that. But look at that nice console stereo system. You know, they sounded decent. You know, they didn't sound anything close to a good 1970s, especially late 70s hi-fi. But they weren't bad. Here's some furniture. Check out the fabric. Is that busy or what? That is very busy. Looks like somebody kind of vomited all over it or something. It's so gaudy. But you know, that was the styles back then. Here's some nice living room suits. Rustic oak. And this would be called early American. They're calling this contemporary, this gold colored one. Check out that chair. They call this one up here, it says bold and modern. It's pretty neat looking in its own right. This one says California Modern. And there's those pole lamps. He had a pole that was spring loaded. So bottom end touched the floor and the top end of the pole touched the ceiling. And then you had a bunch of lights mounted on it. Yeah, everybody had those, it seemed like. Decorator Modern. This is this blue one at the top. Versatile Modern is this one. And at the bottom you have Simplicity Modern. So yeah, you got the whole set for what? A couple hundred dollars? $270. This one is Spanish Mediterranean and French Provincial. I had to look at that word. I don't think I've used a word like that in a long time. Provincial. How do you say that? French provincial. This one says, Millionaire vinyl furniture with new sophisticated contemporary tuxedo styling. $149 would get you the couch and the chair. Night and Day, Morocco Vinyl Group. nice blue. Sophisticated and massive four-piece. Sectional. $218. And it's sitting there amongst all that shag carpet. Oh, and that fireplace. Wow. That's pretty cool. And there's some recliners. And there's some, what they call dinettes. Usually you have a dinette in a large kitchen. The great big dining room tables made out of wood. You typically have those in a separate dining room. Sure have a lot of styles to choose from. Here's bedroom suits. So get this. Here's a five-piece bedroom suit and table, bed, chest of drawers. Yeah. A dresser and a big mirror to go with it. $184. So, furniture has definitely gone up a lot since 1969. Here's some bunk beds. And my brother and I, we had bunk beds. Finally, at about the age of 12, I got my own room. We moved in to a bigger house, so I got my own room at that point. But apparently it was haunted. That's a whole different story. Mattresses. Desk. Playpens over here. High chairs. Swings. And cribs. My daughter is having a baby next month. I'm having to prepare a nursery here at my house so that when she comes over, she has a place to lay the baby down for a nap. Boy, look at that. That's a pole shelf system. Didn't the Brady Bunch have something similar to that? You know, that room where the kids watch TV. Seems like they had something like that, but I can't verify that. There's some adding machines. So I think this might have been before pocket calculators came out. I know I got my first pocket calculator in about 1975 or 76. I still have it. It still works. You've probably seen it. It's a Texas Instruments TI-30. It's been featured in one or two of my videos. Sewing machines. Vacuum cleaners. And hair dryers. Irons. Iron and boards. So many people don't iron their clothes these days. So tell me in the comments if you have clothes that you iron, or if you don't iron, or maybe you just kind of hang them on a hanger and steam them to get the wrinkles out. And there's some wall clocks. Coffee pots, blenders, electric mixers. Toaster ovens, toasters, electric carving knives, waffle grills. Tableware, dinnerware, now we're into the cameras. There's some Polaroid land cameras. That's a model 350, 340, 320, and another 320. These look a lot like my Polaroid 250 Land camera. Here's a 360. I think I've got a video that I featured my Polaroid 250 in. So you might have seen that video. There's some movie cameras, 8mm. I have one of those laying around here somewhere. Someday I should get my 8mm movie projector out and just play some films. I wonder how good a video that would make, or if it would be annoying because the film projector makes a pretty good bit of noise. There's some telescopes and binoculars. Never ever buy a department store telescope. It'll just frustrate you. There's some watches. Mouse watch. There's some pocket watches down here in the bottom. Pocket watches are pretty cool. There's some nice wedding ring sets. Yep. Diamond rings, engagement rings. Here's some men's rings. I have a video that I show you a bunch of men's jewelries, rings, cufflinks, stuff like that. That was passed down to me that belong to my uncle, who's deceased. So maybe you've seen that video. There's some decorator weather instruments to hang on the wall. And some luggage. Lunch bags. Thermos bottles. And when I was in elementary school, we carried our lunches in metal lunch boxes, kind of like that one right there. I had one that had the the Roadrunner on it. And the thermoses were, you know, lined with glass. And most kids, you know, ended up dropping the thermos, and of course the glass would break inside. Space heaters, electric blankets. Freestanding fireplace. Gas heaters. And oil-fired heaters. And console humidifiers. Dishwashers, water heaters, washer dryer combos. Boy, our dryer is making a lot of noise these days. It's Maytag. Probably 30 years old. I've kept it running myself over the years. Same thing with a washing machine. But the truth is, I'm getting tired. Getting tired of keeping them running. Every time I turn around, something needs to be fixed. Most recently, it was one of my cars. It ran good. And then the next time I got into it, it wouldn't start. Here's some refrigerators. So I did the troubleshooting on the car. And it turns out that a mouse or a squirrel or something ate the wire insulation off of the wires that go to the fuel pump. Ate the insulation right off the copper wires. So the copper wires were touching one another. So every time you turn the key to start the car, it would blow a fuse. That was for the fuel pump. So luckily I was able to fix it fairly easily without any cost. I thought the fuel pump was bad. But the truth is, you know, especially in the Honda Accords, the fuel pumps don't really go bad very often. Pretty dependable. Unless a mouse eats the insulation off of the wires. You see, back when that car was made, and maybe they still do, but to be eco-friendly, they used wire insulation that was made of a soybean product. I don't understand. There's no wisdom in that, because you would think that somewhere along the lines the engineers would say, hey, before we make all of this wiring with a soybean insulation. Let's throw some of that insulation in the hamster cage and see if the hamster likes it. And if the hamster likes it, the mice and the squirrels probably will too. Think of how many people have been left stranded and couldn't get to where they needed to go because a mouse ate the insulation off the wires. Sometimes I just don't understand why we do the things we do. But enough about that. Here's some lights, kitchen lights, and outdoor lamppost lights. Here's some wiring here. Here's the copper wires. The copper wires, and you can see the insulation. Here's some house paint. Ladders. I see some air compressors, paint brushes, spray guns. Kitchen cabinets, stainless steel sinks, garbage disposal, bathroom vanities. There's a bathroom cabinet. Bathroom fixtures. You see, back then, we called them toilets, but in the catalog, I don't guess they use the word toilet. They call them bathroom fixtures or water closets. Yeah, water closet. It's another name for a toilet, I guess. You know, I was watching something on YouTube where HGTV had purchased the house that was shown in the Brady Bunch TV series, whenever they showed a scene from the front of the house, this was the house that they showed. The filming of the show never occurred at this house, but this is just a house that they liked the design, how it looked from the street. So HGTV bought it and then remodeled it to look just like the Brady Bunch house. And they were talking about it. And they mentioned that in the Brady Bunch TV show, you never ever saw a toilet because it was considered taboo to show a toilet on TV back then. clean pegboard for the workshop. Window awnings and a patio cover for your patio or your porch. Electric drills. Wow. That was back when they were all stainless steel. Or maybe not even stainless steel, but just nice, shiny steel. Or maybe they were polished aluminum, I'm not sure. Same thing with the circular saws and the jigsaws. Nice metal casings. Even the power buffers, the polishers, nice shiny metal casings. Table saws. Nice wood lathe and electric motors. Torch kits, welding arc welders. Here's some hand tools, wrenches and whatnot. I was just thinking back to when I was about 17. My dad gave me a tool set for Christmas one year. Here's toolboxes. Some of you have asked to see a video of my hand tools, my wrenches and screwdrivers and stuff. You sure you want to see that? That might be kind of a boring video just to see a bunch of wrenches and stuff. But a snowblower, metal sheds. You know, these metal sheds don't cost very much more than they did back then. The only reason I've been looking at them lately. I have a generator, a portable generator. I was going to get a small shed or something to put it in my backyard, so whenever I need to run the generator to power the house in case of a power outage, if I had the generator in some kind of shelter to keep it from getting wet, might be a wise idea. And yes, I did install a transfer switch. Here's a fence charger. Here's a chainsaw. 5.5 horsepower engine. That's a nice chainsaw. There's a 6.5 horsepower engine on this one. 19-inch far. Cabin tent, sleeping bag, camp stove, and a camp heater. Hunting outfits. Yep, hunting we will go. I remember these hand warmers. You put them in your pocket. And here's some shotguns. Some more shotguns. $76. Wow, 12 gauge. Automatic, $76. Those were the days. So more shotguns. Here's some rifles. Marlins, Mossberg, Stevens, Revelation, Remington, Winchester. I was looking to see if my Marlin 22 was on here. I don't see it. Nice bolt action 22. It's nothing like a good bolt action 22 rifle. Check that out. $38. $38 for a rifle. $44. Things were inexpensive back then. There's a lever action 30-30, less than $80. And it has a scope on it. Here's a 30-06 for $100, $103. There's a 308 or a 243 for under $100. And they got scopes. Got some amazing price tags. Bunch of scopes and ammunition and reloading devices. Pistols. And gun cabinets. You know, these days, people store their rifles, their long guns, in usually steel gun cabinets or steel fire safes. I don't know of anyone that's actually storing their long guns in glass wooden cabinets these days. I certainly don't know of anyone that is storing their guns on these wooden racks anymore. And I had one of these back in the day. In high school, a lot of us had guns in our cars. In our pickup trucks. Here's a classic example. Here's the back window of a pickup truck, and there's a gun rack. And it was allowed. You know, we had pocket knives in our pockets, and quite a few of us had guns out in our cars, in our trucks. And when we got into fights, and you know, youngsters do that, we had our share of fist fights. But it was a different age, because no one ever even considered taking the knife out of their pocket or getting a gun out of their car. That was wrong. We all knew it was wrong. And so we didn't do it. Now, I'm not going to say it never happened somewhere. But in general, even though we had guns, we had knives, we didn't use them on each other. It was just a different age. Different era, different day. Different time. Oh, here's 10 speeds. I do love the bicycles. I still ride a bike. I ride a bike on a regular basis. Just last weekend I rode 20 miles. I was going to ride today, but the air quality was pretty low today, so I decided to stay in the house. Here's the banana seat bikes with the high-rise handlebars. And some tires and inner tubes. Yep, these are the kind of bikes that we were riding as kids. And a lot of these bikes came with nice wide slick tire in the back, kind of like, you know, drag racing was a big thing on TV and stuff back then. And the kids all wanted bikes that reminded you of a drag race car. Like, here's an example. This bike has a wheelie bar on it. You know, the drag race cars had wheelie bars. This bike has a steering wheel and a gear shifter right here. Yeah, bicycles were pretty cool back then. And in real cars, you had instead of white walls, you had a red line. You know, even the bicycle people copied the red line tires. I knew Mattel copied the red line tires in their little diecast cars. This bike, much like the chopper motorcycles back then, has a big sissy bar on it. Now, you don't see that these days. These crazy handlebars. The sissy bars, the banana seats, the gear shifters right there on the crossbar. Yep, bicycles were cool back then. Bicycles were cool back in the late 60s and in the early 70s. And then somewhere along the line, these BMX bikes came along. Your banana seat bikes and high-rise handlebars all kind of died out. And there's little children tricycles. I can remember having a tricycle. Did you have a tricycle when you was a kid? Do you remember it? Tell me in the comments what you used to ride when you was a child. Was it a tricycle or was it one of those big wheels, or maybe a tractor looking deal, or a pedal car. Oh, yep. I remember this stuff. Here's the wagons. Me and my friends had a wagon. We used to pull it around the neighborhood. We had some bricks and concrete blocks and pieces of wood. And it was kind of like our traveling Evel Knievel show. We would set we'd park the wagon and take the stuff out of it and build up the bricks and the blocks and put the wood. It was like and then we would jump our bicycles. You know, we'd build a ramp. We'd jump our bicycles. Kind of like Evel Knievel. Then we had the neighborhood kids would lay down on the ground and we would jump over them. I think my record back then was 6 kids. shoulder to shoulder. And the last two kids would always wear, we always made them wear a football helmet. Just in case we landed on their head. There's a slot car track. Lots of toys. Dollhouses. Barbie dolls. There's an electric football game. Hey, there's a spiral graph. I should get mine out and make a video of a spiral graph. Swing sets and ice skates. Wisconsin has a lot of lakes. My dad used to love to ice fish. He'd take me along. When I got tired of ice fishing, I would just skate around on the lake. There's sleds and the saucers. You ever go down a snowy hill on one of these metal saucers? I think there was a scene from National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation where Clark went down a hill on a saucer. There's the metal roller skates that you put. You put them over your shoes. I had some of those on one time when I fell, broke my wrist. Actually did that. I fell on these skates and broke my wrist on the very day that I got a cast taken off of my wrist from where I broke it. When I was pulling on a tree branch and the rope broke. So my mother was just livid that I had to wear a cast for weeks, and then I got the cast off, and on the same day, I broke it again. Oh, I'm sorry, Mom. I'm sorry for what I did. Just drove you crazy, I'm sure. Here's some BB guns. Just looking to see if they got the one that I had. I don't see an exact match. But if I had to guess, mine looked much like this one at the top. Or my first one looked like that. My second one was a Crossman. My first one was a daisy, and you just kind of had a lever that you cocked. My second one was a Crossman, and you had to pump it up. Footballs and basketballs. Soccer balls, tether balls. Pool tables. I like to shoot pool. table tennis exercise equipment. Archery. Now this is a Western Auto catalog, and it took until we got to page 181 before we saw anything that had to do with automobiles. And here are some seat covers for automobiles. Then floor mats. And timing lights. That's what we use to set the timing on engines. And aftermarket gauges and tachometers. And car vacuums and various accessories. Side view mirrors for cars and trucks. Shock absorbers and brake shoes, carburetors, fuel pumps, mufflers for exhaust, water pumps, motor oil and oil filters and air filters, battery chargers, spark plugs, alternators, starters, and the starter has been kind of acting up on my old pickup truck. I replaced it one time since I bought the truck new. And it was pretty difficult to replace it because of it just wasn't a lot of room to work. But it looks like I'm probably gonna have to do it again sometime in the future. Batteries. Wiper blades. Tire chains for driving on ice and snow. Jacks. And tires. Yeah, I think this is before radial tires, maybe. Because these are all, these aren't radials. These are all bias ply tires. But, you know, $30 for a tire, or even less. You know, for $100 you could get a set of tires. It's crazy what tires cost these days. Of course, you know, a gallon of gas back in 69 was about 35 cents. You could buy a whole new, brand new car back then for a little over $3,000. You know, your average house was 15,000-16,000 back then. You could rent a house for $135 a month. Pricing has really, really gone up since then. So we're at the end of the catalog. And I, at the beginning of the video, I asked the question, could a catalog that was over a half century old, could it make you sleepy? So, if it made you sleepy, tell me in the comments. Maybe you won't even hear me say that, because maybe you're asleep. But if by chance you're still awake, you can tell me in the comments that you managed to stay awake for the whole video by telling me that Western Auto had it going on. Yeah. Western Auto really had it going on. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it relaxed you. I hope it comes out good. That's yet to be seen. If you're watching it, I guess it came out good enough. Take care.